Hello children, welcome back. In our last class, we had studied three important organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes and mitochondria. In this class, today we will be studying further two important organelles, Golgi apparatus and blastids. Children, have a look at the eukaryotic cell, which has a very unique feature or which is characterized by possessing membrane-bound organelles, which are subunits having different functions. Today, we will learn Golgi body. So let us see where is generally Golgi body located in the eukaryotic cell. You will generally find Golgi bodies present near the membranes of the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the nucleus. You will also see them scattered in the cytoplasm. And children, there are many tiny subunits, that is dictyosomes, especially in plant cells. Now, let us see the enlarged structure of the Golgi body or the Golgi apparatus. Children, this organelle is so named because of the name of the discoverer. Camillo Golgi was the first one to discover this organelle, hence the name given to the organelle is Golgi apparatus. If you carefully study the structure, it is made up of flattened tubules having swollen ends that lie parallel to each other. This is the concave end of the Golgi body and this is the convex end of the Golgi body. The concave end is called the cis face, whereas the convex end is called the trans face. These rounded or ovoid structures that you can see, they are called vesicles. Now, what is the function of this particular phase? Children, you have to understand that they are located near the endoplasmic reticulum. So, whatever proteins or products that are made near the endoplasmic reticulum, they are received by this concave phase or the concave end of the apparatus, that is the cis phase. These proteins or any product that has been obtained from the endoplasmic reticulum then enters the matrix or the lumen of the Golgi apparatus. While they are passing through the lumen, they are modified and according to the need of the cell, they are at this end, that is the secreting end called the transphase, packaged into vesicles which are called secretory vesicles, which are then transported to different target destinations within the cell and outside the cell. So, in a single line, you can say that this organelle serves the unique function of storage, modification, packaging and dispatching of products produced near the endoplasmic reticulum. Few more extra things I would like to explain, which you will not find in your NCERT children, is that even the lysosomes, which are the suicidal bags of the cell, they are also derived from the membranes of the Golgi bodies. And the structure called acrosome, which is present in the head region of the sperm, that is the male gamete, is derived from the Golgi body. This acrosome present in the male gamete or the sperm has Golgi apparatus in it, within which different enzymes are released which dissolve the wall of the ovum or the female gamete for the purpose of fusion, that is fertilization. You have learned, children, in reproduction that fertilization takes place when the male gamete sperm fuses with the ovum. So this acrosome present in the head region is derived from the Golgi body, which has the ability to dissolve the wall of the ovum for the formation of zygote for the process of fertilization. So at least these are the basic things, children, which you should know about Golgi apparatus. And before we proceed towards the next organelle, let us recapitulate what we have learnt about this particular organelle. Golgi bodies was first discovered by Camillo Golgi and is present in all eukaryotic cells. It originates from the membranes of the rough endoplasmic reticulum. It is a disc-shaped organelle having two faces. The concave face is called the cis face and the convex face is called the trans face. They act as receiving and secreting ends respectively. Functions of the Golgi apparatus include modification and packaging of materials coming from the endoplasmic reticulum. It takes place in membrane-bound transport vesicles which are sent to different target destinations. Golgi body is also involved in synthesis of lysosomes, and the acrosome in the head region of the sperm is derived from the Golgi apparatus, which contains enzymes that helps the sperm to get through the wall of the ovum for the purpose of fertilization. Now we come over to the next organelle, that is plastids. Children, plastids are generally present in plant cells and algae. They are absent in animal cells because plastids contain pigments that have the ability to trap the solar energy for making food or for imparting colors, which is a very characteristic feature of plant cells and algal cells. They are absolutely absent in animal cells. Let us see the types of plastids. Children, plastids which are present can be of two types: colored plastids and non-colored plastids, or colorless plastids. The colored plastids are of two types: the green plastid, chloroplast, and the other colored plastids which impart colors other than green, like red, yellow, orange, etc., to different flowers, fruits, and other plant parts. Children, the non-green chromoplasts or the colored plastids are generally imparting those vibrant colors to flowers, fruits, which help to attract insects for pollination and also are helpful in seed dispersal. But when we talk about the green colored plastid, it is a chromoplast. Chromoplast means a colored plastid, okay? And chromoplasts are of two types. One is the green plastid having a green colored pigment called chlorophyll, and the other are chromoplasts which are having colors other than green, okay? So in your syllabus, you are supposed to study the structure of the green plastid, which is called chloroplast. Children, if you see the structure of the chloroplast, it is ovoid in shape, having a double membrane. You can see inside the matrix, inside the fluid of this chloroplast, there are structures which are called grana. Each unit is called a granum, and there are several grana inside the matrix. This granum is made up of ovoid structures which lie flattened one above the other. Each ovoid structure is called a thylakoid. So you can say that the granum is made up of several thylakoids which are packed one above the other like a pile of coins. This unique structure is called grana. You can see it is green in color since it's a green plastid. And what is imparting this green color? These thylakoid membranes or the granum contains the green pigment chlorophyll, which has the ability to trap the solar energy for photosynthesis. This is actually the place in the plant cell where photosynthesis takes place. And the food is prepared for the plant in the form of the simplest sugar, glucose. The fluid matrix enclosed within the double membrane of the green plastid is called stroma, and the granum lie embedded within the stroma. You can also see it has its own DNA and ribosomes. Hence, just like the mitochondria, even plastid is a semi-autonomous organelle which can synthesize its own protein and can produce its own replica. So this is the structure of the green plastid chloroplast, which has a unique function to perform, that it is the kitchen of the cell. It is the site or the place in the plant cell where photosynthesis will take place.
Unlike the grain plastid, the other colored plastids do not perform photosynthesis. In fact, they impart colors other than green, like red, yellow, orange, etc., due to presence of pigments called xanthophylls and carotenes, which impart these vibrant colors to different plant parts. So, this is about the colored plastids. Now, coming over to the colorless plastid. Since they have no color, neither do they perform photosynthesis, nor do they impart any color, then what is their function? Since they are colorless, they are called leucoplasts. Okay, the green plastid is called chloroplast and the colorless plastid is called leucoplast. Leucoplasts generally are involved in the function of storage, and they are present in plant parts which are not generally exposed to the sunlight. They are present in the roots and underground stems which are not exposed to the sunlight. So their main function becomes storage of food. So let us study about the plastids. Plastids are present in plant cells, algal cells, and they are absent in animal cells. They can be broadly classified into two types, chromoplasts, which are the colored plastid, and leucoplasts, which are the colorless plastids. Chromoplasts can be further classified into the green plastid chloroplast, having the green pigment chlorophyll, non-green chromoplasts, which have carotenes and xanthophylls. They are the pigments which impart colors other than green to flowers, fruits, roots, and they attract the insects for pollination. Let us study the chloroplast. As I had shown you the diagrammatic representation, chloroplast is ovoid in shape. It is bounded by a double membrane. It encloses the fluid matrix called stroma. Within the stroma lie units called grana. Each granum consists of membrane-bound sacs called thylakoids, and the membranes contain the green pigment chlorophyll. Chloroplasts trap the solar energy with the help of chlorophyll, and they transform the solar energy to chemical energy, and food is prepared in the form of glucose. So the green plastid chlorophyll, that is the chloroplast, is called the kitchen of the cell. Leucoplasts are the colorless plastids which occur in cells that are not exposed to sunlight. They are mostly present in the storage cells of the roots and underground stems. They are of three types: amyloplasts, eleuroplasts, and elioplasts. Amyloplasts are those leucoplasts which store starch. Eleuroplasts, they store proteins. And eleoplasts, they store oils and fats. So children, in this class, we have learned the structure and function of two important organelles, Golgi bodies and plastids. This is all for today, children. Thank you and have a nice day.